Hello viewers, welcome back to the automotive basic session. This is Omshekhar Ajivi. Today my topic is how to calculate CRC in CAN network. So CRC calculation in CAN network. Today the agenda is what is CRC, what is the purpose of CRC in CAN network, and what is mean by error detection, how to select g of x. I'll tell you what exactly g of x means, how to decide CRC and CRC calculation. Before getting into the topic, so I would like to say about terminologies. The terminologies I will be using g of x, m of x, x to the power of r m of x. G of x is generator polynomial, m of x is message with sequence of data bits the transmitter is going to transmit, x to the power of r, m of x with appended zeros. I'll discuss about this m of x with appended zeros exactly what while I'm doing CRC calculation. Here, let's say for example our CAN network, I'm considering only two ECUs. So let's say for example ECU 1 and ECU 2. So here the transmitter and receiver, how the CRC calculation is done in our CAN network, so we will see later. So before getting into the details, I would like to discuss about our agenda. First, what is CRC? The CRC is the error detecting code commonly used in digital networks to detect accidental changes to our data, whatever the transmitter is going to transmit to the receiver. And what is the purpose of the CRC? The purpose is to detect the accidental changes are errors which are induced because of noise in the CAN network. What is meant by error detection? Error detection means the errors which are caused by noise or other impairments during transmission of our data from transmitter to the receiver. How to select g of x? As I said, g of x is the generator polynomial. So this will be decided by system engineers or system architect. So this must be chosen according to the error detecting capabilities in a CAN network. CRC calculation. For this, I will be explaining with example. Now let's look at this diagram. I have ECU 1 and ECU 2. Consider this is my CAN network. So the ECU 1 is the transmitter which is going to transmit T of x as a bit sequence to receiver. So I will call it as determine T of x based on G of x and M of x. Let's see in future how we will determine, how our transmitter will determine T of x using this G of x and M of x, so called generator polynomial and sequence of data bits. So what receiver will do? Check whether the remainder equals to zero. If the remainder is not zero, it will treat the transmitted data as error and it will discard the data. So as we know, in our CAN network, it will ask for retransmission of the same data. So after calculation of T of x, the transmitter is transmitting T of x as a bit sequence to receiver. So the next step is this one. So the next thing is, if I consider how to decide CRC. So as I said, the CRC must be chosen in order to detect more errors in our CAN network. So here, two things need to be considered. The first thing is generator polynomial, and the second thing is XOR operation. The ECU or the receiver, the transmitting or receiver, which is going to calculate CRC or which is going to compare with the calculated CRC, both should be aware of these things, the generator polynomial and XOR. So this will be done in transmitter and receiver with three steps. What will happen? The transmitter will share a generator polynomial with each other, or any other SU is going to transmit the data in the first point, the second and third. Share g of x. Obey with g of x should be capable to generate binary the first point share the g of x between transmitter and receiver. The second point both should obey with the shared generator polynomial. The third point both the transmitter and receiver should be capable of generating the binary representation of our g of x. So we will see how to generate binary coefficients for that. Let's say for example our g of x, x is equal to x to the power of 4 plus x to the power of 3 plus x plus 1. So we have the highest degree is x to the power of 4. That means our CRC will be equal to 0. So the way to decide which bit CRC, let's say for example in our CAN network we will say 15-bit CRC. So the highest degree of the polynomial in 15-bit CRC is x to the power of 15. That's the reason in CAN network the CRC will be equal to 50. So here how to write the binary representation of this g of x. Let's say for example 1 x to the power of 4 term we have. So 1 into x to the power of 4, 1. So x to the power of 3 term also we have. 1 into x to the power of 3 is equal to 1. There is no x to the power of 2 term, so no generator polynomial. 1 into x to the power of 1 is equal to 1, and this will be constant. This constant and this generator polynomial will be derived according to linear algebraic stuffs. So let's say for example now our binary representation of generator polynomial g of x is equal to 1 1 0 1 1. And as I already said, to calculate CRC, any transmitter or receiver must aware of generator polynomial and XOR operation. Here I am considering XOR operation for two binary operands. Let's see the truth table. 0 XOR with 0, the result is 0. 0 XOR with 1, the result is going to 1. The 1 XOR with 0, result will be 1. 1 XOR with 1, result is 0. That means it clearly indicates that for the binary value with the same value, the result will be 0, hence the result will be 1. Now we will see how to calculate CRC in our CAN network. How exactly transmitter is calculating and receiver is calculating, and how exactly it is comparing, and how it is deciding whether the transmitted message is error free or not. So let us consider matching. So let us consider the sequence of data bits 1 0 1 1. Any data you can take 0 1 0 1 1 0. This is my sequence of bits. So now we have to derive t of x using this m of x. Now we have m of x, so we need g of x as well. So g of x, let us consider x to the power of 3 plus x to the power of 2 plus x to the power of 1 plus 1. So as I already explained you, the size of CRC is here the highest degree polynomial, which is x to the power of 3. So we are going to calculate 3-bit CRC. Since it is 3-bit CRC, to calculate our
t of x using m of x and g of x, we have to append three zeros to the m of x at right side. So let's see what happens at transmitter side. So this is our transmitter. What transmitter is going to do, it can network now. So I'm going to take m of x 0 1 0 1 1 0. So since transmitter is going to calculate 3 bit CRC, we have to append 3 zeros to the right. And we know our generator polynomial, and now we have to calculate binary representation of the generator polynomial. X term, x to the power of 3, as I already explained, 1, x to the power of 2, x to the power of 1 term is not there. So 0, the constant. 1, 1, 0, 1 is our g of x. 1, 1, 0, 1. So g of x is the divisor, m of x is the dividend, and as I already explained, quotient will be discarded and remainder will be the CRC, calculated CRC. And now we are all familiar with our XOR operation. Let's start with the calculation. 1101. We know the truth table. 0, 1, 1, 0. Take this, discard this. 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. So, 0, 0, 0, 1. Discard the quotient once again. Consider next 3 bits 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. These 3 bits. Our g of x is 1101 once again, all zeros according to our truth table, quotient will be 0. Consider the next data bits 1100 till here, since we have discarded all the 4 bits. 1101 0 0 0, discard all 1, the remaining 2 bits. So this is our CRC. So as I already explained, we are going to calculate 3 bit CRC. So the calculated CRC also we found 100 in binary format. This is a transmitting cell. So this is our T of X. One zero one one zero one zero one 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 zero one zero zero is the T of X. That means transmitter has sent to receiver. Now at receiver side, what will happen? Let's see. Now we have calculated T of X. We have T of X. That means whatever the bit sequence transmitted by ECU1 to ECU2. Now let's see what receiver or ECU2 will do it. Let us consider our T of X, the transmitted sequence 10110100111100. So this is the calculated 3 bit CRC. We already know our g of x 1101. As I already said, the transmitter and receiver must be shared each other, the g of x, and must obey each other with the g of x. Let us consider the g of x 1101. Take the data bits 0101110100. Perform the same operation whatever performed by the transmitter 1101. We all know our XR operation 0, 1, 1, 0. Discard the quotient, take the next weight, 1, 1, 0, 1, again our g of x, 1. Discard the quotients, 1, 0, 1. Discard the quotient and our g of x, 1, 1, 0, 1. According to truth table, all zeros. Yes, discard the quotient. Next, 1, 1, 0, 1. Consider the g of x, once again 1, 1, 0, 1. According, follow the truth table, all 0, discard it, we have lost two zeros, 0, 0. So, at the receiver side, the remainder equal to 0. That means the transmitted bit sequence is exactly received by our receiver. This is one way of calculating CRC in a CAN network. Another way, as we all know, and we all studied in CAN network, the transmitter will calculate CRC and it will send it as a t of x, and receiver will recalculate the same CRC for the received bits and it will match. That means in our CAN network, we are not, the receiver is not looking for the remainder 0, it is looking for the remainder 100. So in this way, CRC is calculated in the CAN network. So this is the way of calculating CRC. That's all from today's presentation. Keep watching our videos, and for further queries or doubts, subscribe to my channel and comment on the same channel. So I'll get back to you soon.